Welcome to Argentina. Located in South America, this vast country ranks in as the eighth largest in the world, covering almost 2.8 million square kilometers. While Argentina is often associated with soccer legends like Messi and Maradona, there is much more to discover beyond the field. In this video, we'll be highlighting our time spent in the European-style capital of Buenos Aires, and the world-renowned wine country of Mendoza. If you're new here, then welcome. We're excited to bring you another travel-style video from around the world. So join us as we take you on our 7-day journey through the picturesque country of Argentina. The first stop on our trip was to Buenos Aires, the capital and largest city in the country. With its captivating blend of European influences, this city has earned its nickname, the Paris of South America. Throughout the city, you will notice many landmarks, statues, and monuments, some of which were gifts from countries like France, Spain, and Italy, and others were built with help from European sculptors and architects. Given that roughly 95% of the population is of European descent, these icons hold historical significance and represent the strong ties between Argentina and Europe. The first thing we did in Buenos Aires, like we do in almost every place we visit, was a tour to explore the city. Since the capital is so big, you'll need to find a bus tour to navigate the different parts. One of the more interesting stops we made on our tour was Caminito Street in the very colorful neighborhood of La Boca. This is one of the most famous streets in all of Argentina and is known for its brightly painted houses that are still occupied today. Also, a fun fact about this area is that it's said to be the birthplace of tango, which we'll be covering later on in this video. It's not every day that you wind up in a cemetery, especially not one of this magnitude. Meet the Cementerio de la Recoleta. What makes this cemetery different is its unique design that resembles a miniature city with street-like blocks. This layout was influenced by the urban planning principles during its establishment in the 19th century and gives a feeling of wandering through a city dedicated to the memory of the deceased. During our visit, we were able to admire the many sculptures and mausoleums as we spent a few hours viewing the resting places of some of Argentina's most celebrated people. After spending a few hours in a cemetery, it's probably best to switch up the mood. In that regard, if scenic walks in the park are up your alley, we would recommend a stop by the Japanese Garden. For a small fee, you can spend the afternoon enjoying the sunlight and the views of the meticulously kept garden. Practically right next door to the Japanese Garden is a great free alternative. The Paseo El Rosedal Garden might just be on your itinerary if you're looking to get some fresh air away from the city. Also, if you want to spend the entire day exploring, there's a bunch of great parks all around this area for you to check out, including a zoo. Founded in 1858, Café Tortoni is the most famous and oldest continuously operating café in the city. After beating the long lines, you are met with a jam-packed café chock-full of rich history. However, we weren't here just for the coffee or cake. Café Tortoni, along with many other venues across the city, offers a chance to witness the iconic Argentine dance form tango firsthand. At the tango show, we were able to enjoy our dinner accompanied by the tango performance and even had a chance to try the café's famous hot chocolate and churros alongside their dulce de leche for dessert. In a country that has more cows than people, you can bet that they know a thing or two about meat. A common street food in Argentina is choripan. This dish usually consists of bread filled with chorizo and topped off with a chimichurri sauce and a salsa a la criolla. Alongside choripan, Argentina is very well known for their flavorful and tender steaks due to its abundant supply of high-quality beef from grass-fed cattle. Another thing that is popular in Argentina is the traditional drink mate, which is a tea-like beverage made from the dried leaves of the yerba mate plant. And when I say popular, I mean really, really popular. So popular, in fact, that if you look around you in public, it's almost impossible not to see someone holding a cup of it. While visiting Argentina, we were fortunate enough to have some locals make a cup for us to try, and surprisingly enough, we ended up liking it so much that we bought our own setup to make mate at home. While Argentina is known for its choripan, steaks, and mate, the country is more recognized for its wine. However, to witness wine at the source, we must take a 2-hour flight to the premier wine-producing region of Mendoza. Located at the foothills of the Andes in West Argentina, lies the wine capital of Mendoza. This is a common getaway destination for Argentines looking to benefit from its laid-back atmosphere and vineyard-exclusive wines. Within Mendoza, there are several subregions that are known for specific styles of wine, like Malbec, Cabernets, and Chardonnay. Although we came during the off-season when all the crops were dead, we still opted in for a half-day wine tour to get to experience the many vineyards that surround the city. For your convenience, we'll put a link to the wine tour and any other tours that we covered in the video description below. The tour started with us getting picked up in front of our Airbnb, and then we drove 40 minutes to the first of 3 wineries. Each of the wineries were owned by different families and were unique in their own ways. Some of the wineries used traditional methods of winemaking, while others used the latest and greatest machinery and technology. And, of course, throughout the tours, we got to help ourselves to many delicious varieties of wine. As an added bonus, we also had time to visit a local olive oil producer and learned about the olive oil production process. Overall, this was a very thorough tour and we'd highly recommend it to anyone visiting Mendoza. A big thank you to all who have made it this far in the video. I'm hoping that I've done justice to Argentina and didn't put you to sleep. These videos do take a lot of effort to produce, so if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to the channel, give this video a thumbs up, and let us know your thoughts in the comments section below. And by doing so, you'll help spread this video to fellow travelers. So thanks again for tuning in to another travel video brought to you by yours truly, Backpack Gringo.